Welcome back to yet another day in the vlog. Just finished cardio. Was good. Was difficult, which is great. I love it when it's like that. Like, I felt at one point I wanted to spit. Whew, but it went great. Gonna spray on this mat, sanitize it. I used 15 pound weights this morning, and we're gonna head out in a few for a morning walk. This morning's was hard and high intensity cardio workout. We did some of everything. We did body weights, and then the next workout would have been dumbbell body weight, 30-second work, 30-second work, then 30-second rest or 20-second rest. 20-second rest was good. I really enjoyed it. Flawless Beauties, let's continue Proverbs chapter 23. We're going to go from 17 straight up to 28. Now it says, do not let your heart envy sinners, but always be zealous for the fear of the Lord. There is surely a future hope for you, and your hope will not be cut off. It says, listen, my son, and be wise, and keep your heart on the right path. Do not join those who drink too much wine or gorge themselves on meat. For drunkenness and gluttons become poor, and drowsiness clothes them in rags. Listen to your father who gave you life, and do not despise your mother when she is old. Buy the truth, and do not sell it. Get wisdom, discipline, and understanding. The father of a righteous man has great joy. He who has a wise son delights in him. May your father and mother be glad. May she who gave you birth rejoice. My son, give me your heart, and let your eyes keep to my ways. For a prostitute is a deep pit, and a wayward wife is a narrow well. Like a bandit, she lies in wait and multiplies the unfaithful among men. Now, verse 17 to 18, yeah, these two portions of scripture here, it says, how easy is it to envy those who get ahead unhampered by Christian responsibility or God's laws? For a time, they do seem to get ahead without paying any attention to what God wants. But to those who follow him, God promises a hope and a wonderful future, even if we don't achieve it in this life.
Good evening, all kings and queens that have subscribed to this channel. I'm on my way to collect babe and then drop him off to his rehearsal, and then I'm going down to voice training. I was only able to rehearse this song in totality today, and that's a shadow, because I was like, my arms are very buff. I was only able to like run through the song today. I was listening to it all of yesterday while I was getting my lashes, and I was listening to it, and this is the song that we have to prepare for today's voice training. And it is, oh my goodness, I'm gonna put it on the screen for you guys to see. And it's such a beautiful song. It is a very dynamic song because it calls for a lot of belting. And I remember the first time I tried belting, the next, like, remember when I don't know, it was a day I had to minister and I wore a green dress, and I was like, I don't know if I'm able to get through this, but God is going to take me through. If you guys are watching vlogs, I think you guys know what I'm talking about. So when I was rehearsing, it's the same lady, Natalie Grant, yes. And I was rehearsing, no, your presence is my greatest weapon. I think that's what it is, the name of the song. When I was rehearsing that shot my voice, because I did not have the correct technique, and I was practicing on my own. And then I got to learn a little bit more about my vocal cords and how to relax them, because those are notes that I'm not accustomed hitting. You guys know that we up in the rafters with my vocals, but not really in my chest resonance. I've not really practiced that, So that really brought me out of there, and I really focused on songs that challenged me in that aspect last voice training. So this one is very similar to that, but a lot more dynamic. And girl, I just pray that I get through great in the name of Jesus, and I'm better able to sing songs with more versatility. Yeah, I have that versatility is what I'm really trying to say. Not only be in the rafters, or not only sing really soft and melodic kind of songs and stuff. So anyways, I'm not gonna talk your ears all the way off. Today was just full. I completely forgot that I had to do edit a video, so that video you guys saw, get ready with me to go to the penthouse, that was a long journey, something I think it is, that I'm gonna edit tomorrow and put it up for tomorrow, because tomorrow is gonna be Friday. And I already edited the first part of the vlog for Sunday, and I have to break that down in two parts, because that's a lot, and I didn't realize I had so much footage. For the moment, I realized I vlogged so much. So there is that, and then I'm wondering if I should, let's see how it goes though, but I'm wondering if I should break my vlogs down and give you two vlogs a week, one on Sunday, one on Wednesdays. You know, I like follow on like a series. Jeez, back there is Loch Ness. These massive trucks, father. My love, good evening. You zip and zip on the bag, that part is it one zipping. Bag won't close it. Good? Good. Mm-hmm. You're doing strange things. Alright, so babe, all dropped off at rehearsals. I am so cold, and this thing down at 1. Not on my way now to rehearsals. Voice training, as mentioned.
not do that. Okay? All right, so let's have a look at our tongue twister. So maybe we're looking at number 2, number 5, number 10.
2, 5, 10.
Number 2, number 5, and number 10. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck? How much wood would a woodchuck chuck? If a woodchuck could chuck wood. So emphasis on the letter K.
So we're not going into one woodchuck, just at the question mark. We're finishing at the question.
Okay, who would that?
No. We don't need to know. I'm just joking.
We don't need to know.
Chuck wood.
How much wood would a woodchuck chuck? If a woodchuck could chuck wood. Oh. If you want to look up,
How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? As much as he could, and chuck as much wood as a woodchuck would, if a woodchuck could chuck wood. Could chuck, yeah.
Ah.
Morning. We're going to finish Proverb 23 today. So we're going from verse 29 down to verse 35. So it says, who has woes? Who has sorrow? Who has strife? Who has complaints? Who has needless bruises? Who has bloodshot eyes? Those who linger over wine, who go to sample bowls of mixed wine. It says, the soothing comfort of alcohol is only temporary. Real relief comes from dealing with the cause of the anguish and sorrow and turning to God for peace. Don't lose yourself in alcohol. Find yourself in God. And this doesn't only pertain to alcohol. Anything that you're using to fill that void, turn to God. Yeah, turn to God. It says here, do not gaze at wine when it is red, when it sparkles in the cup, when it goes down smoothly. In the end, it bites like a snake and poisons like a viper. Your eyes will see strange sights and your mind imagine confusing things. You will be like one sleeping on the high seas, lying on top of the rigging. They hit me, you will say, but I'm not hurt. They beat me, but I don't feel it. When will I wake up so I can find another drink? Israel was a wine-producing country. In the Old Testament, wine presses bursting with new wine were considered a sign of blessing. Wisdom is even said to have set her table with wine. But the Old Testament writers were alert to the dangers of wine. It dulls the senses. It limits clear judgment. It lowers the capacity for control. It destroys a person's efficiency. To make wine an end in itself, a means of self-indulgence, or as an escape from life, is to misuse it and invite the consequences of the drunkard.
Hello, kings and queens. I'm here wrapping up the edits for the paint roses, actually. Same now. Just finished the thumbnail as well. So I want to respond to some of your comments on camera. And our first comment comes from Lucy, and this is under my maintenance video where we did nails, lashes, and my everything, pedicure, you name it. I was kind of skeptical about uploading my pedicure, because getting down your nails and showing all that. But I know there are some persons like myself out there like to see extractions and stuff like that, like just things being cleaned. So I didn't mind putting it in for that purpose. So yeah, Lucy says, this was so calming and the background music made me feel like I was in a spa. You're welcome, gorgeous. I hope you're doing wonderful. Our next comment, thank you first very much for your comment, gorgeous. Thank you. Next comment comes from Lucy, and this is under Our Life in Barbados, one of my vlogs, The Right Way to Manifest. And she says, well, if you decide to do Vlogmas again, okay, this year, just keep it short, 15 minutes max, and end the series on Christmas Day, if time on your schedule permits. Anyhow, you have all year to plan. Thank you, gorgeous, very much for that insightful information and suggestion. You guys know I love to take your suggestions in. I may push for a little bit more than 15 minutes because just for algorithm purposes, and what else to end on Christmas Day, that was the goal. But I think this is my first time doing Vlogmas, and I realized in order for it to finish on the correct day, which is Christmas Day, I think I have to start Independence Day. I think that is the correct thing. Yes, November 30th. So, as you rightly said, I have the entire year to plan. It's always planned, to be quite honest. But thank you once again for your suggestion. Really appreciate it, guys. Leave me your comments. Leave me your suggestions kindly, please. All right. Thank you very much, Tricia, for your comment. Our next comment comes from Amanda Vlogs, 9056, just in case. And this is under our Absolute New York full coverage liquid matte foundation. And it says, that's our review, and she asks, what store did I buy that foundation? I purchased that foundation from Paradise Beauty along with that concealer. So I'm going to respond to you, gorgeous. Thank you very much for your query, and I'll let you know exactly where I bought that from. And thank you very much for your comment. Our next comment comes up from Tricia. I don't know, I was going to say some other name. And it's on our Valentine's Day 3-in-1 get ready with me. Oh, that's such a good time. I think that was one of the most memorable Valentine's there for me, and the food was great, ambiance was great, outfits was great, company was great, everything was just great. And I really liked it as well, because I planned from early, and therefore a lot was like just fell into place. So planning really, really helps. Taking your plans and putting them up to God really, really helps. Don't care what it is. You could think it's small and God is not going to care. He's caring here. He cares. Trust and believe, you're the apple of his eye. So yeah, Tricia said you should draw a fantasy makeup video someday in the future. I need details on the side tables, please, and thanks. Okay, side tables in our bedroom. That is a vase with a piece, not a piece of glass, with a circle glass, no, circle mirror, not glass, two different things, circle mirror on top, and then the, what do you call that, the lamp, ooh, lamps, I got lamps from SAS, glass, those were, you can get that glass from anywhere you want, but I got that from Jubilee. I think Jubilee is in Tuisai Road. If not glass, Sasco, or you can just buy the normal thicker mirrors from like SAS as well. And those vases, I got those vases a while ago from Big Tang. Right, so you can stop one place and get all, well, not one place, one area, because Big Tang is just across from SAS, if you want to use or get that look as well. Yeah, hopefully I find a set of side tables that I like. I am still looking, yeah, but that is what we have currently. Thank you very much for your question, gorgeous. And under that same video, Tracy asks once again, oh no, she says, you look too sweet. Oh, she said, oh, you are right too, Dario. She has four laughing faces. I good.
Wash it my hands. Okay, I'm not getting any of that.
Hey, but thank you very much for your compliment on me. You and Dario, y'all will start that all. Okay. Not getting that, period. Our next comment is from Tricia once again under one of our vlogs. I was asked out on a date. That was part of the title of the vlog. And she says, I need the details on the side tables, please. And thanks. That's her asking again. And you got your response. Definitely leave me your comments. Leave me your questions. And I will answer them for you guys. So thank you very much. This wraps our little time spent answering your questions. I have some more here as well, but I want to leave that for a video, an upcoming video. Yeah. So yeah, guys, I will see you guys. Where am I going? Where am I going? I'm so accustomed to wrapping off a video after vlogging. So yeah, guys, I am going to finish off the rest of my work, and I'll talk to you guys very soon.
Good evening to one and all. How are we doing? I am on my way now into town. Actually, I'm in town with babe. Turn through here. I turn through here. Trying to find a part at this point in time. Babe is going to get his hair cut. And that's pretty much it, I guess, for the rest of the evening. I don't know how the rest of the evening is going to go, but I was able to upload that video that you guys would have watched, that penthouse video. I was able to upload that. I was glad about that. And the footage for the Sunday vlog is still giving a bit of trouble. That will be for Wednesday. You guys are going to see that the middle of the week. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for now. Workout sets. I know I just glued on workout sets.
Let me paint the picture for you. I forgot this love you can't afford you. Till it pours up lavishly upon you. It makes this love shine so bright upon you.
For a minute, I just wrapped up some ironing, and yeah, we're about to eat. We're gonna have some fish and chips this evening, and we're gonna finish watch Creed part 2. To me, it's not as exciting as part 1, but we'll see. So I'll see you guys tomorrow.
I know this song. Cause my drive and my party. Hey, to man, I need go. You're my provider. Yeah, you're my provider. You
Hello, kings and queens. I hope that's not too loud where you guys can actually hear me. Babe is in the front rehearsing once again, and I am about to record for you guys this event that we are going to. So stay glued for that. We didn't do much today, honestly. I was just chilling, relaxing. Let me just close in some of the door. Trying to really relax. But that wasn't really happening for the most part. So I'm going to go ahead and do this recording for you guys, and I will talk to you as soon as I am finished.
We're on our way down, guys. I think this is where I'm going to end this vlog. As I mentioned before, you guys are gonna see all the details in an upcoming video. Babe brought shoulders. His shirt is actually in the back, and it's one of those like linen shirts. So, in a sense, putting in creases you don't really want just yet, because he has to play the sax also. So yeah, guys, I'll see you guys in the next vlog. Bye, guys. Don't forget to hit that circle button to subscribe to my channel, and here are two more of my videos. See you soon!